Hi, welcome back to the studio. We're here in the forest with a young man by the name of Paz Faigenbaum.
Hi, Henry. How's it going?
Welcome back to Australia.
Lovely to be here.
And you're flying out today back to Israel.
Yeah, in and out.
In and out.
Yeah.
We had you on years ago as a permaculture guru.
That's
maven,
right.
I should call you a maven because we love all the Yiddishkeit. A maven is an expert or someone who knows.
Yeah? Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
You are from the Hebrew of mevin.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I know. I know you, and you're one of my favorite people because you are such a proactive gardener.
Right.
So what's your shtick?
What's my shtick? All right. Well, I'm based in Jerusalem forest in Ein Karem. Mm-hmm. It's quite wonderful. I've had the schut, the merit to receive this beautiful land, 15 acres of land in Ein Karem, Jerusalem forest. And we're cultivating not only community, but actual really healthy animals and food production, security. And it's a place that we can not only have education, but retreats and festivals on the Jewish Hagim itself. So
you go with every season, you have a special, the Jewish seasons particularly.
Yeah, so each festival has the spiritual component,
yeah.
And then has the follow-up actual practical permaculture farming component. So
the relationship to nature.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So in Sukkot, the time that we pray for rain, we had the rain dance festival.
Uh-huh.
And we had like African dance and embodying, how we use our bodies to pray for rain. But then we had rainwater collection in the landscape, like workshops of how we use the landscape to hold the water.
So,
But Tu B'Shvat's coming up.
That's right. It's coming up in Australia and in Israel. It's on the 9th and the 10th of February, which is actually it's known as the New Year of the Trees.
Yeah.
So we celebrate the tree.
It's also my birthday.
Really?
Yeah. So it's a, and I think that's the beautiful thing about Tu B'Shvat is that it's not only, it's the time where the sap starts to rise. From after the winter, the trees begin to come up and start to flower.
So it's a rebirth.
It's a rebirthing, but it's also the time in which we can embody to awaken ourselves. So, we have our own tree of life. We have the Tu B'Shvat Food Forest Festival, something I've been running for over 7 years. And we get a big turnout, over 100 people come.
So you'll be back for that, of course.
So, basically, we have, during the middle of the day, a food forest workshop, and it's how we create a sustainable agricultural model that's based on the Jewish cycles of Shemitah. So every 7 years, we rest the land in Israel.
Correct. Fellow.
Yeah, exactly.
You're a jolly good fellow.
So we think about, for those 6 years, what can we do to prepare the land that it can be hydrated, fertile, and to have a lot of fruits that we can share with the community. So I run the Jerusalem Food Forest Group. We've got our initial one in the middle of the city, and this is going to be the second one on a much bigger scale.
Right. So. Well, you've really done a great job in cultivating community.
Yeah.
Here in Australia when you were here, and then you've now moved the whole shtick to Israel.
Sure.
And Israel is so way ahead in innovation, in environmental sustainability, isn't it?
You could say in some ways it is, like in terms of the actual technology, there is a lot of amazing irrigation and technology. But I suppose it's quite a transition, in Israel there is the we live for today kind of mentality.
Yeah, I know.
But that's slowly starting to shift, and I think that's the beauty of, say, for example, the food forest system, which is about resiliency and long-term strategies of how we can produce fruits for the next generations. And I see that is happening more and more, and we have to create these healthy systems and really kind of advocate that and educate that together with not only the children, but I have in March the Shmitah Permaculture Design course. So it's a 1 month course, which is the foundation is permaculture, and then we weave in all the principles of Shmitah, of what it is to share food, what it is to create trust, to create storehouses. There's like real ideas in the land of how we have interpersonal relationships, a paradigm shift of how we work in relationship with one another, not only individually but as a community. So that's a holistic program that people can join and apprentice.
Your surname is Faigenbaum,
right,
which is in Hebrew or Yiddish, it means a fig tree.
Fig tree.
Yeah, and your name, the name of your group is Fig,
right?
Which is food integrated gardens.
That's right. Yeah, I mean that's, you know, that's getting the source of it.
Mm.
Fig, food integrated gardens, being a fig tree, being rooted in the land, and there's we have a nursery. We're producing many different figs, and you can like it on Facebook. There's Fig. Food Integrated Gardens, or the website www.foodandgardens.com,
and also on Instagram
is Paz Fig. Too easy.
Thank you very much. You've got a plane to catch, mate.
Yeah, I know. Thanks, Henry.
We're rushing along.
One last thing is, yes, we're in the nighttime of the Tu B'Shvat Seder, when we get the big crowds, we have the Kabbalistic Fruit Seder, which we have a big temple of fruit.
Yep.
And we have different wine sponsors. So we have four glasses of wine,
yep,
each world, like Pesach.
Fantastic.
And it's a time to create meaningful connection, not only to awakening, but to the fruits of the land. So, you know, can we keep on cultivating community is the idea.
That's what it's all about.
Excellent.
Thanks very much. We're going out with a bit of your music.
Wonderful.
And we'll be back next week with more Shtick. In fact, Ronit Fraid from the JNF, we forgot to mention, it's Green Sunday.
Wonderful.
This week as well, which coincides with Tu B'Shvat. And we'll have Ronit talking about how they went with all their volunteers. They're calling for volunteers and people to get on the phone and make it happen, to raise money. And all the programs, all the money goes to Israel.
Well, the Australian-Israel connection is important.
Very important.
Got to keep it real.
You are definitely part of it.
Thanks, Henry.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Hi, I'm Paz from Food Integrated Gardens Retreats. So here it's really special. We're going to be gathering in nature to experience the Jewish festivals. Yeah. And we're putting on a Kabbalistic fruit seder, and also we're going to be building a food forest in the heart of Jerusalem City. Life force is flowing through the crown.
The world of action, the lowest humane, the kind of like ground world.
Life is too boom to be jaded and stasis. Ki ha adam ein dasadeh.
Ki ha adam. 2, 3. What I'm going to transition to now is the idea of Shemitah. Does anyone know about Shemitah?
I think that it's about letting go of control, because the land does not belong to us.
Essentially, it's the idea of creating a resilient system and a resilient community, abundance, in a public space where there is equality, where it is that we can, you know, sink roots and share, and not be territorial, but like share our fruits.